regardless of what kind of injury you've suffered, you need to drink more water. There's some scientific reasons why, and if you don't, it really affects your healing in a negative way. Find out why in this week's edition of Health Matters. When it comes down to it, we're all nothing more than hairy, skin-covered bags of water. It's estimated that of our trillions of cells, up to 75 trillion, up to 85% of that full mass is water. It's fluid. And there's a reason for that. We need fluid in order to make things fluid and to make things move, to make things stay hydrated and working right. And when we don't get enough water, called dehydration, we start losing function at every level. It not only affects our organs and our tissues, but it also affects our mental cognition. Everything runs on water. So, first thing, how much water do you need? Well, in order to stay hydrated at the ultimate way, here's a great rule of thumb. All you have to do is take your body weight in pounds, and so let's say you weigh 200 pounds, divide that number in half, and drink that much water in ounces. So if you weigh 200 pounds, a half of that is 100, you'd want to drink about 100 ounces of water a day. And ideally, you want to spread that out throughout the day, so you're not drinking 80 at one time and then 20 at another time. Your body wants to use this stuff throughout the day. If you drink too much at once, your body's going to have to process it, and essentially, you're just going to get rid of a lot of it. Okay, so when it comes to drinking water, take it in little bits at a time and calculate it through that formula we just gave you. Now, check this out. I'm gonna show you an example of what happens on the inside when you have water and dehydration and time working together in a bad way. Here's a nice normal disc. You can see it here, nice and full right there. And when we look at a disc that's dehydrated, we're gonna see that it's a lot more squished. There's gonna be a lot more breakdown between the bones of the spine. And that same dehydration can happen in any different tissue. Now, the problem is, especially when we look at spinal discs, as they get older, they don't take in water near as well as they did. So imagine every day we're bouncing from walking, from sitting, from driving, from standing. And that water just kind of squeezes out of these discs throughout the day. And then at night when we lay down, it resorbs and it comes back into the disc. Well, over time, the more water goes out, the less water goes in. The more water goes out, the less water goes in. So imagine the compounding effect of that if we don't bring in enough water from the outside. Now, not only are we squishing out water, but we don't have enough water to begin with. So being dehydrated actually accentuates or accelerates a lot of our negative health processes. Additionally, if we don't get enough water, we don't do enough motility or movement in our guts. So things slow down and you can get toxin built up in your guts. It also has an effect on your heart, your lungs, your kidneys. All of these tissues need to be well hydrated. Your muscles, your skin, they need water too. So now that we've talked about how much water and why it's important, here's the thing that I'm gonna tell you. When you're drinking water, if you don't like water, it's still not a reason. Because by the way, pop is not water. Beer is not water. Coffee is not water. Tea is not water. So if the taste of water is something that you have a hard time with, all you have to do is take some of these little drops, and you can find them. They're not full of sugar. They're just natural elements of different flavors. You can get cinnamons and mints and lemons and all these things, and just put a little bit of that. Another delicious way to get your water is take up different fruits, and you can find whatever fruit and veggie combo that you like and put that into your water and make it far more tasty if, again, the taste of water is something that bugs you. So you can get, for example, cucumber and celery makes a nice one. You can put some strawberry in water. You can put mint in water, lemon, and you can combine these things. So try out which ones work for you and then stick with it and make a big pitcher so that throughout the day, you know, you're gonna drink that full pitcher of water and you're gonna stay hydrated. So until next time, drink up. Remember, it's your health that matters.